Exercise 13.1, problem number 4, evaluate probability of A intersection B. If 2 into probability of A equal to probability of B equal to 5/13 and probability of A, conditional probability of A for given B is 2/5. The conditional probability of A for given B. The conditional probability of the event A on the occurrence of B is given as 2/5. And 2 into probability of A equal to probability of B equal to 5/13. In such case, probability of A intersection B. So, given here, probability of A on the occurrence of B is 2/5. That implies, by definition of the conditional probability, this is probability of A intersection B by probability of B equal to 2/5. I thought that this is probability of A union B, not intersection. Okay. Probability of conditional probability of A on the occurrence of B is 2/5. By definition of the conditional probability, this is probability of A intersection B by probability of B is 2/5. So that implies probability of A intersection B is 2/5 into probability of B. Probability of B. This is 2/5 into probability of B is given 5/13. Hence 2/13. So by addition theorem, probability of A union B is probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. But probability of A, 2 into probability of A is 5/13. So probability of A is 5/26. Probability of B is given 5/13. And probability of A intersection B is obtained as 2/13. So, the required probability is, here the LCM is 26. So, 5 plus 10 minus 4. This is 11/26. The probability of A union B is 11/26. Next one. Fifth problem. Exercise 13.1, fifth problem. If P of A is 6/11, P of B is 5/11, and P of A union B is 7/11, then find the first one is probability of A intersection B, the second one is conditional probability of A on the occurrence of B, and the third one is conditional probability of B on the occurrence of A. Given probability of A is 6/11. Probability of B is 5/11. And probability of A union B is 7/11. That implies by addition theorem, probability of A union B is PA plus PB minus P of A intersection B is 7 by 11. Already P of A, P of B is given. So therefore 6 by 11 plus 5 by 11 minus the probability of intersection is 7 by 11. So that therefore, now coming to 1, therefore probability of A intersection B, probability of A intersection B is 6 by 11 plus 5 by 11 minus 7 by 11. This is 11. In the numerator we get 6 plus 5 minus 7. So this is 4 by 11. The required value of probability of A intersection B is 4 by 11. So now conditional probability of A for given B is probability of A intersection B by probability of B itself. That is 4 by 11 by probability of B is 5 by 11, which is 4 by 5. Similarly, the conditional probability of B for given A is probability of B intersection A by probability of A itself. The probability of A intersection B is same to that of probability of B intersection A. Hence, this is 4 by 11 itself. By probability of A is 6 by 11, which gives us 4 by 6, that is 2 by 3. The conditional probability of B on the occurrence of A is 2 by 3, whereas the conditional probability of A on the occurrence of B is 4 by 5. Probability of A for given B, probability of B for given A. These two need not be equal, need not be equal here. Moreover, this is not equal to P of A. Here P of A is 6 by 11, whereas P of A for given B is 4 by 5. These two are different and these two are different. Next one. A coin is tossed. An unbiased coin is tossed. Coin means unbiased coin. Three times. A coin is tossed three times. Where the first one, E stands for head on third toss. F stands for event of heads on first two tosses. Then determine and find probability of E on the occurrence of F. Find the probability of E on the occurrence of F. The prior event is F here. Posterior event is E. After happening of F, E was happened. Once getting of heads on first two tosses and probability of getting head on the third toss. That probability is required here. So, once a coin is tossed three times, a coin is tossed three times. So the sample space contains the possible outcomes are here. The possible outcomes are getting head on the first toss, getting head on the second toss, and getting head on the third toss. This is one possible outcome. Similarly, head, head, tail. H, T, H. T, H, H. These are all the possible outcomes of this experiment. Totally 8. So N of S is 8. Total possible outcomes of the experiment, random experiment, is 8. Now E. The favorable possible outcomes to E. E stands for head on third toss. Head on third toss is possible in these cases. This one and this one and this one and this one. Head on the third case, third toss is possible in four cases. And F is getting of head in first two tosses. That means HHH possibilities, HHT, these two are possible outcomes to, favorable possible outcomes to F in first two attempts, in first two tosses, getting of head. Possible outcomes are HHH, HHT. So N of E is here. N of E is 1, 2, 3, 4. N of F is 2. Here E intersection F. E intersection F is HHT. HHH, this is 1. And HHT, no. This is only 1. HHH. So that implies N of intersection F is 1. Now the probability of probability of E on the occurrence of F, the conditional probability of E on the occurrence of F is probability of E intersection F by probability of F. That is N of E intersection F by N of F itself. Or you may write it as N of E intersection F by N of S by N of F by N of S. Okay. This is 1 by 8 by 2 by 8. So which gives us 1 by 2. The way of finding the conditional probability of E on the occurrence of F. In the same problem, in second problem, a coin is tossed 3 times, and where E stands for at least 2 heads, at least 2 heads. This is at most 2 heads. At most 2 heads. Then find, in this case also, probability of E on the occurrence of F. Okay. The random experiment is same. Tossing of an unbiased coin 3 times. Once a coin is tossed 3 times, the possible, total possible outcomes are this. Hence, this is a sample space. So, the total possible outcomes, number of total possible outcomes are N of S is 8. Now, as per the definition E, is at least two heads. At least two heads and means two or more heads. Two or more heads. You may get two or more heads. So this possibility is happen in this case and in this case. In this case also, two or more heads. Getting of two or more heads. E stands for event of getting two or more heads. At least two heads means that is two or more heads. And F stands for at most two heads. At most means maximum. Maximum number of heads is two. That means two or less than two. Less than or equal to two heads. That is less than or equal to two heads. At most two heads means less than or equal to two heads. The possible outcomes to this event. Getting of less than or equal to two heads. Getting of two heads is HHT. Getting of two heads. And getting of one head is possible in these cases. Getting of no head, that means all the coins shows the tiles. These are all the favorable possibilities to F. So that implies here N of E here is, that means 4, and N of F is here, this is 4, 5, 6, 7. 7. Now E intersection, E intersection F. E intersection F means the common possible outcomes. Here the common possible outcomes are HHT, HTH, THH. HHT, HTH, THH. So therefore, N of E intersection F is 3. Okay. Now, therefore, probability of E on the occurrence of F, the conditional probability of E on the occurrence of F is probability of E intersection F by probability of F itself. That is nothing but E intersection F by N of S by N of F by N of S itself. By definition of the probabilities, probability of E intersection F is N of E intersection F by N of S. That is 3 by 8 by N of F. N of F is 7. 7 by 8. So the required one is 3 by 7. You can remove this 8. Similarly, we can able to find conditional probability of F on the occurrence of E also. Like that, you can able to do the third bit also in this problem. I will leave it to homework. Similarly, seventh problem. Two young coins are tossed once. Two coins are tossed once. Where E stands for tile appears. Appears on one coin, on one coin, any one of the coin. F stands for one coin shows head, one coin shows head. Find probability of E on the occurrence of F itself. Probability of E on the occurrence of F in this case. For this random experiment, if both E and F are defined in such a way, we have to find the conditional probability of E on the occurrence of F. Coming to solution of this problem. If two coins are tossed at a time, two coins are tossed once, then the possible outcomes, the sample space, the possible outcomes are either two coins are tossed means either getting of head and head, head and tile, tile and head, tile and tile. The possible outcomes are on one coin getting head, in another coin again getting head. Similarly, on the first coin getting head and next tile, tile and head. Tile and tile, like that. So n of s is here 4 clearly. The total possible outcomes of this random experiment is 4. Now E. Event of getting tile on one coin. This is the event of getting tile on one coin. So that the favorable possibilities, these are all total possibilities of the experiment, favorable possibilities to the event getting of one coin, getting of head on one coin, is HT or TH. Getting of tile on one coin. Okay. Event of getting tile on one coin is HTTH. F is event of one coin shows head. One coin shows head. So one coin shows head, possibilities are HTTH. Therefore E intersection F, the common values is getting of HTTH. One coin shows head, so that E intersection F is HTTH. Therefore, N of E intersection F is 2. N of F is also 2, which is nothing but N of E itself. Therefore, probability, conditional probability of E on the occurrence of F is probability of E intersection F by probability of F, which is nothing but N of E intersection F by N of F itself. N of E intersection F is 2, N of F is 2, hence 1. So hence The conditional probability of E on the occurrence of F is 1. Hence, the conditional probability of E on the event E for given F. E for given F is certain event because its probability is 1. Because its probability is 1, it is certain event. Therefore, event E on the occurrence of F is certain event. Is a certain event because its probability is 1. It is a certain event. The same problem, the second bit is, two coins are tossed once where E stands for no tail appears. No tail appears. F stands for no head appears. Then find the probability of E on the occurrence of F, the conditional probability of E on the occurrence of F itself. The conditional probability of E on the occurrence of F. Okay. Here the random experiment is tossing of two unbiased coins once. Then the possible outcomes, the total possible outcomes are either getting both heads on both the coins and getting of head and tail. Similarly, getting of tail and head, and both shows tails. So, these are the total possible outcomes of this experiment. So, N of S is 4. Now, E is defined as here, event that no tail appears. Event of no tail. No tail appears. So, therefore, favorable possibilities to E. Favorable possibilities to E is event of no tail appears means getting of both heads. Getting of both heads is E. Similarly, F stands for event of no head appears. No head appear. Therefore, F, the favorable possibilities to F, getting both tiles. Here, the intersection of E and F is clearly 5. Here, there is no common possible outcome. There is no common possible outcome to both E and F. Hence, their intersection is 5. Therefore, N of E intersection F is 0. N of phi is 0, no element. Therefore, probability of E on the occurrence of F is N of, by definition, N of E intersection F by N of F is 0 by N of F. N of F is here 1. That is 0. The required probability is 0 itself. Once the probability is 0, then that event is an impossible event. Probability of getting. Probability of getting no tail. No tail. On the occurrence of no head appears. Is 0. So, therefore, here E on the occurrence of F is called is an impossible event. Impossible event because its probability is 0. Next one. Eighth problem. Problem number 8. A die is thrown 3 times. And E stands for here. 4 appears. On the third toss. F stands for event of getting 6 and 5. Appears. Respectively. On first two tosses. Then find probability of E on the occurrence of F. Okay. Let us find the total possible outcomes here and then favorable possible outcomes to the events E and F. Here the random experiment is an unbiased die, once it is not given as die, unless and otherwise specified, the die or coin is considered as unbiased. So an unbiased die is rolled 3 times. This is our experiment. An unbiased die is rolled 3 times. So therefore, straight away I will write N of S. Each time a number appears on the die which lies between 1 and 6, 1 to 6. In each toss you may get the number between 1 to 6. So, in the first toss, we have 6 possible outcomes. In the second toss, we have another 6 possible outcomes. And the third toss also, we have 6 possible outcomes. So, the total possible outcomes are 6 into 6 into 6. 6 into 6 into 6. This is 216. 216. That is total possible, the number of total possible outcomes. We cannot list out all the possible outcomes of this experiment. You cannot list out all the possible outcomes of this 216 possible outcomes. So hence, straight away I am writing the total possible outcomes, the number of possible outcomes of the experiment. Now, E is, what is the E? E defined as event of appearing 4 on third die, on third toss. So, event of getting 4 on third toss. So, the favorable possible outcomes are, once you fix 4 in the third one, you get only, therefore, N of E is 6 into 6, because on the third toss, we get 4. Means, in the first toss, either you may get 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 6. In second toss also, you may get 1, 2, 3 and until 6. But whereas, in the third toss, we must get 4. So, the total possible favorable possible outcomes to the event is only 6 into 6. That is 36. Of course, since is, I will take it as 114, 124, 134, like this. 164. Okay. Similarly, 214, 224, like this. So these are all 36 in number. Hence, n of e equal to 6 into 6, that is 36. And f, the other event, event of getting 6 in first toss and 5 on second toss. Event of getting a particular number 6 on the first toss and appears 5 on the second toss. So n of f, the favorable possibilities are only 6, since f contains 6 5 1 6 5 2, like that 6 5 3, and so on 6 5 6. Okay, these are all favorable to f, because on the first toss we get 6, the number 6, and in the second toss we must get 5, in the third toss the number may vary from 1 to 6. So therefore, E intersection F here, the common possible outcomes, the possible common possible outcomes to E and F is only 6 5 4. This is one and only the common possible outcomes to E and F, because on the first toss we have to get 6, on the second toss we have to get 5, based on E we have to get 4 on the third toss. So therefore, n of E intersection F is clearly 1. Hence, probability of E on the occurrence of F is probability of E intersection F by P of F, which is nothing but n of E intersection F by n of F itself. This is 1 and n of F is 6. So the required probability is 1 by 6. The required probability is 1 by 6. So like that you can able to find the conditional probability of E on the occurrence of F for given events E and F. The conditional probability of E on the occurrence of F may be evaluated. Next one. In all cases, we cannot list out the possible outcomes. Once you cannot list out the possible outcomes, we have to go through the permutation combinations to get the possible outcomes, the number of possible outcomes. Problem number 9. Mother, father and son line up at random. F for a family picture. For a family photo or picture. E stands for sun on one end. F stands for father is in middle. Father is in middle. Find the probability of E on the occurrence of F for the given events. Find the probability of E on the occurrence of F. Okay. Here the random experiment is just a standing of a mother, father, son in a line at random to a family picture. Okay, mother, father, son, line up at random for a picture. So the possible outcomes are, the possible outcomes of are mother, father, child or son. This is one order of standing the family members to the picture. And M, C, F. This is one more. This is one more possibility. Or this is one more possibility. Okay. This is MFC, MCF, okay. CMF, CFM, FMC, FCM, in the first place mother will stand, and F and C may be interchanged. Similarly, child, mother and father and mother. Similarly, F, M, C, F, C, M. Okay, three places, three to be. So here there is three places, three persons be arranged in these places, three places and three persons may be arranged in 3P3 ways. So 3 factorial by 0 factorial, that is 3 factorial, that is 6 ways. Okay, it's 3P3. 3 factorial by 0 factorial, that is 6 ways. Therefore, N of S is 6. The total possible ways of standing the 3 persons in a line to the picture is 6. Out of this total possible outcomes, E. Even that the sun is one end. The sun is one end. So the favorable possibilities are M, F, C. This is one possibility. and the other possibility is FMC. FMC and the other possibilities. FMC. CMF. CFM. CFM. C is completely at right end in these two possible outcomes, and whereas C is completely in left end in these two possible outcomes. So at one end means either right end or left end, both possibilities that you have to consider here. So N of E is clearly 4, and F. F stands for father is in middle. Father is in middle case. That is possible in these cases. MFC and CFM. MFC and CFM. There is no other possibilities here. So N of F is clearly 2. Here E intersection F. E intersection F is the favorable possibilities to this event. The father is in middle and the child is at one end. That is possible here two ways. Two ways. MFC, CFM itself. This both to be considered, both to be considered here. The father is in middle as well, the child is at one end. So N of E intersection F is clearly 2. So required a probability, the conditional probability of E on the occurrence of F, the conditional probability of E on the occurrence of F is clearly N of E intersection F by N of F itself. By definition of the conditional probability, straight away you can take it. So that is 2 by 2, that is 1. It is also certain event here. But whereas the probability straight away, the probability of E, happening of E is 4 by 6, 2 by 3. The probability of E straight away, once evaluating the probability of E, we get N of E by N of S itself. That is 4 by 6, that is 2 by 3. So for E, the sample space is S. For E given F, the sample space is reduced to F only. That is the difference between straight away the probability of E and probability of E for given F. The total sample space is restricted to this F only here to define this probability.